So when I first encounter a baby, I do an overall gestalt impression of how this baby is doing. Is this a sick baby or a well baby? Does the baby appear as I would hope, or are there signs of trouble here? So there are three hallmarks of that overall gestalt. The first is skin color. Is the baby pink, well perfused, or pale mottled? This baby is pink, well perfused, and when I touch her, her extremities are nice and warm. Warm toes, warm feet, so her circulation is intact. Second is respiratory rate, and we can see this baby is breathing comfortably and easily. Without counting the respiratory rate, I would estimate this at about 40. If it's above 60, that would be an indication that the baby is breathing fast, and with a little experience, you can distinguish tachypnea in a baby quite quickly. Also look for signs of intercostal retractions, nasal faring, or grunting. This baby is breathing very comfortably, so she's passed on all three of the critical elements of a limited physical examination. And those three findings give me a great deal of reassurance that this baby doesn't have a serious illness. In particular, that examination is sufficient to reassure us that this baby is not in the process of developing a serious bacterial infection. Beyond these things, I look for the luxuries that the baby has. This baby has the luxury of being very relaxed, sleeping comfortably. I will not wake her at this point, but a few minutes ago she was awake, she was looking around, she was responding to social interactions, and just a short time ago she was able to take her feeding without any difficulty. All of those things are luxuries that are not necessarily required for a baby to stay alive for the next few minutes, but of course will be for staying alive for a long period of time. But this baby is able to exercise all of those luxuries: feeding, social interactions, awareness, being alert, being interactive, and having good muscle tone. This is a very nice baby who I find very reassuring just to look at her.